How so?
It's not even that simple.
How am I being hard on them? Where are you from?
England.
Well, you've got your own problems. You're in a tyranny there. No wonder you must love tyranny then.
It's a doctrine. We're finally getting rid of the IRA. Finally, people see what they're about. War aid stops, all that, and then suddenly there's something else. There's always something.
Yeah.
There's always something.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean we have to stop it. I mean, shouldn't we, you know, why should that mean we have to accept it? I mean, why should we have, just because it's always been that way, why should we accept that?
It's depressing, but I think what you're fighting now is an ideology, a very perverse ideology. And going around shooting people doesn't make it any better. In fact, it's only got worse.
Well, who's talking about going around shooting people?
Well, the very provocative things about the Nazis you got here, and you're very pro-guns, I can see.
Yeah,
which I find
for protection.
If they're so good at protecting people, how come 91 people per day get shot in the USA?
And a lot more get saved. They don't tell you that, do they?
91.
They don't tell you about the ones that get saved by guns, do they?
Lots of people won't move here, like me, because of the gun laws.
What happens when your government decides to just take you over and put you in a camp?
Never.
Huh?
That hasn't happened.
But what if that time were to come, if they wanted to do that? I mean, we have FEMA camps, but I have a woman, as a matter of fact, I have this confirmed by several people, a major the other day confirmed this. We have FEMA camps built all over this country. Concentration camps. They built over 800 concentration camps in this country. They're built, they're staffed, they're stocked, and they already have prisoners in it. I have had this confirmed. And I'll show you the documentation if you wish to see it. So, they're built. They're there and they're ready and they're trying to take our guns. Now, if the economy collapses, which it's going to do.
Again.
Big time this time. Yeah, but this time it's going to be for real. This time it's going to be make the Great Depression look like a walk in the park. So when the shelves empty, there's going to be civil unrest and riots. So if you don't have guns, if you can't protect yourself, you're dead. If the government wants to come in and start shoveling us into those FEMA camps, we got no way to protect ourselves from doing that. Let me show you something.
No, that's crazy. If you're going to lose food on the shelves, you don't need guns, you need food.
Yeah,
you
but
need
they,
water, you need sewage, you need everything controlled, you need to be supplied, you need fuel.
And the government's not going to do that.
And the guns aren't going to help you. Just because you've got a gun, you can't run an oil refinery. You can't grow food and process it just because you've got a gun. You need the technology.
Well, I'm talking about, I was here for Katrina, okay?
I'm sure that was scary. Really scary.
Especially when you were hearing gunfire all over the place, and if you didn't have a gun, And then the military came in and took our guns. And then we were left defenseless. And the only people that had the guns were the criminals. So they were running rampant around
that
here.
That must be scary.
Well, a little bit scary, I think. But if you have a gun, it could you know, at least defend yourself against the criminals. I mean, do you think I'm going to wait around for the police to save me? Hell, they were doing a lot of the looting.
I would think that. If you've got a gun against a bunch of criminals, there'll be a lot better shot than you.
Oh, really? Then again, more people are saved here by guns every day than shot.
Evidence for that.
Of course they don't want you to see any evidence of that. They don't show you that evidence.
But it's a free country. You've got free speech. You're speaking. So why is there no evidence? But you got the internet.
Yeah, that's
like
not the government.
Internet.
That's not the controlled media.
You like.
Yo, let me show you. Come here. Look at this. You think that these guys tell us the truth? You think they tell us the truth? You watch this. This was on TV just about a week ago. All right?
European media.
Yeah. Now listen. Listen to this guy.
Russian TV.
Listen to him.
About 25 years. And I was educated to lie, to betray, and not to tell the truth to the public. But seeing right now, in the last months, how far, how the German and American media tries to bring war to the people in Europe, to bring war
the
to Russia.
The German media? What's in it for the German media? What's in it for Süddeutsche Zeitung, Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung, alles diese Zeitung? They kind of problem.
It goes beyond that.
They're just making money for a newspaper.
It goes beyond that. There is a move to form a one world government, and every world leader is in on it.
Yeah. Is it the Bilderberg Group?
Thank you.
You should read the books written by other people about them. And other people, British
politics. Oh, so they get together to do what? Play bridge?
Yeah, they get together to try and organize the world for themselves, but they're not going to get a world order. Bullshit.
Well, look, they seem to be doing a pretty good job of it.
The world is too chaotic for that.
They're what?
The world is too chaotic for them to make any order out of it.
I read quite a bit also. Tragedy and Hope. You familiar with that book?
No.
Quigley. Professor Quigley, who was Bill Clinton's mentor, he said that, right? Was a member of the Illuminati. He wrote the book Tragedy and Hope. We weren't supposed to read that. That book details, 1,500 pages, the takeover of the world. It has been the dream of over every totalitarian since time began. They now have the means to do that because of the technological revolution. The Bilderberg Group, the world elites, the Illuminati. They're inbred. It's the original 13 families, and these people are all part of the same loop. You don't get in there unless you get born into it. It's a bloodline.
They have all the world leaders meet there, the rich, the bankers, and all that.
Yeah, but where do we fit in? We're supposed to be a representative government. You got these world leaders meeting in private, deciding our fate. Screw them! Who the hell are they? We're supposed to be a representative government.
I'm not shouting at you. You don't have to shout at me.
I'm just making the point. Who the hell are these people to tell us how we can live, who's going to be our president, who's going to fight the wars, who's going to live and who's going to die? Who the hell are they? What, because they're elites? Because they're kings and queens?
So you're having a whole voting system for no reason?
Exactly. Our voting system is a sham. It's a complete sham.
You get to vote.
What?
You get to vote.
It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean it. Here, read, live. Yeah, come here.
It's a great system in the youth in America.
Listen to what he says. He's saying the party bosses pick the candidates. The voters don't matter. That's what he's saying there. So our votes don't matter. It's the party bosses. He just told us our votes don't matter. Why even bother holding the primaries? That's a good question.
I don't understand the primaries. I don't understand the system here.
Well, the thing is, we vote in the primaries, and let's say you're a delegate. You represent our votes. As a delegate, you go to the convention and say, this is what the people voted for. What he's saying is, you as a delegate can go to that convention and tell us to go to hell. That it doesn't make any difference what the voters say. It's the delegates or the super delegates or the party bosses. What we voted for. So when you say, we vote, but it don't mean anything. We vote on machines owned by private companies, owned by foreign organizations. The machines have been proven to be remotely manipulated. The votes are counted in secret. We get no paper trail. To say that our votes count is a hilarious joke.
You can't get a coalition government in this country, can you? There's only two parties. That's why
they're both being controlled by the same people.
If you had a coalition, if you could at least get a coalition government, you would get a very different scenario.
Yes.
You can't, because there's no third party allowed in, it seems.
Thank you. So it's a rigged system, isn't it?
I don't live here. I can't speak for your system better than you. I don't know.
Learning about it here. I mean, this is a rigged system.
Yeah.
And as far as that, everything, we're still under the thumb of the Queen, just like you are, just like, matter of fact, since the revolution, when we kicked your ass, right?
No, we left.
Yeah, right, because we were kicking your ass. I make all excuses, but don't make any difference. Here's the disconnect. We've been paying reparations to the Queen since the Revolutionary War, even though we won that revolution.
We were paying massive debts to America after the Second World War, the post-Marshall Plan, which only got paid off a few years ago.
Again, it's all about the central banks. It's all about the people that control things, that loan money to both sides. They funded the communists, they fund us. They funded the nut, Prescott Bush, Senator Prescott Bush, the grandfather of W, the father of Herbert Walker, had his bank seized by the FBI for funding Hitler. That's a matter of fact. So we had one of our senators, who was the father of one of our presidents and the grandfather of another one, who was a Nazi.
Just surprised me. Lots of Nazis.
Indeed. But this, are we supposed to accept this? Should we accept this?
Just accept that. So if you live near Germany, it wouldn't surprise you.
Well, you know, the thing is, right now that because we have the internet, there's a lot more knowledge out here than people have ever known before.
And it's sifting through it.
That's what we have. That's why we have discretion. Yeah. I mean, you look at things and you have your own common sense, and you can say, well, that sounds like bullshit, you know. Mm. Oh, that sounds reasonable. You know, you got that discretion. And obviously what's going on, and you look at it, you say that, you know, with the way the situation in the world is being run, nothing makes sense a lot of times. You look at it and say, this doesn't make sense. It looks just like the opposite of what it... So you can't blame it on incompetence. You can't be this much incompetence in the entire world. So it has to be a plan. It can't possibly be anything else. Are you familiar with Albert Pike?
No.
Albert Pike was the founder of the Freemasons.
I've heard of them.
All right. He was the founder of the Freemasons. He wrote the blueprint for the elites on how they would take over the world and control it. And this is what they said. This is how we were. And you can look this up. This is the papers that he wrote. He prophesied or fomented World War I. What countries would fight it, who would lose, who would win, and why they would benefit. World War II, who would fight, who would win, who would lose, would benefit. Why would they benefit? And he prophesied World War III, and this is what he said. We will take down the Western civilizations using the Islamic State. We will start brush fire wars everywhere, create a bunch of refugees, open up the borders, allow them to come in, overwhelm the wayfield system, create terror within those countries and bring down the Western civilization from the inside. Albert Pike, 1800s, prophesized World War I, II, and III exactly as they're being played out. Look it up.
Clever guy. Good luck.